So let's discuss six limbs of art. The first is Rupbheda, Parmanam, Bhav, Lavanya Yojanam, Sadrishyam and Varnika Bhav. So meaning of Rupbheda is the knowledge of appearance. Rup means appearance. And then Parmanam. Parman means measurement. आप कई बार इसको आप वैसे भी चेक करते हैं कि इसका हिंदी में वर्ड जो है प्रमाण का मतलब रहता है मेजरमेंट. भाव, आप फेस के जो एक्सप्रेशन है वो भाव होते हैं, तो एक्शन ऑफ फीलिंग्स एंड फॉर्म्स. एंड लवण्य योजनम, इट इज़ द आउटर ब्यूटी ऑफ योर आर्ट. एंड सदृश्यम इज एक्चुअलिटी. जस्ट लर्न ओनली वन थिंग, लाइक इट इज़ आउटर ब्यूटी, सदृश्यम इज एक्चुअलिटी. एंड वर्णिका भंग इज द आर्टिस्टिक मैनर ऑफ यूजिंग आर्ट मटीरियल. सो लाइक हाउ यू होल्ड योर ब्रशेज एंड पेन, दिस इज द वर्णिका भंग. देन कम टू आर नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, दैट इज कलर्स. देन यू मस्ट नो हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ कलर्स आर देयर. You need to know about the these three color schemes. One is primary color, one is secondary color, and the one is tertiary color. If we mix, primary colors are the those which cannot be obtained by mixing of any colors. So these are blue, red, and yellow. Then come to secondary colors. These colors are obtaining by mixing two primary colors, and blue and red is violet, red and yellow is orange, and yellow and blue are is green. Then tertiary color, when we mix one primary and one secondary, we get tertiary color like violet and blue, indigo, orange and red, saffron, and yellow and orange, golden yellow or deep yellow. Then come to hot colors, the colors which give effects of heat and have maximum wavelength. मैक्सिमम आप देखिए, गर्मी में आपको मैक्सिमम पसीना आता है, तो आप मैक्सिमम वेवलेंथ इसके अकॉर्डिंग आप इसको लर्न कर सकते हो, एक ट्रिक है. देन रेड एंड येलो, यू नो दैट हॉट कलर्स आर रेड एंड येलो. देन कम टू अनदर कलर्स, कोल्ड कलर्स, द कलर्स विच गिव इफेक्ट्स ऑफ कूलनेस एंड हैव मिनिमम वेवलेंथ. भाई मिनिमम कोल्ड कलर मिनिमम एंड हॉट कलर मैक्सिमम वेवलेंथ. न्यूट्रल कलर्स, द कलर्स विच आर नाइदर स्ट्रॉन्ग और ब्राइट नॉर हैव एनी हॉट एंड कोल्ड इफेक्ट आर कॉल्ड न्यूट्रल कलर्स, लाइक वाइट, ब्लैक, शेड्स ऑफ ब्राउन एंड ग्रे. देन आफ्टर दैट लर्न इफेक्ट्स ऑफ कलर्स. यू मस्ट नो टू इफेक्ट्स ऑफ ईच कलर, लाइक रेड, रेड लव, वॉर, डेंजर, येलो, सनशाइन, वार्म्थ, लाइट, ब्लू, कूलनेस, ट्रूथ, प्लेजर. And then green, relaxation, spring, festivity, fertility, growth, orange, knowledge, bravery, heat, and violet, royalty, dignity, white, peace, unity, purity, black is for depression, darkness, fear, ego, evils. Like you have to learn any two effects of each color. Then our next chapter, that is unit 1, prehistoric rock painting of art of Indus Valley. So, like, we are going to learn these caves, that is Bhimbetka caves. And that was discovered by a brave archaeologist, Dr. Vishnu Vakankar. And that is a natural art gallery. And the location is Bhopal on the way of Hoshangabad in Madhya Pradesh. And spread in an area of 10 square kilometers. What kind of material has been used in this? Like, these are like 500... it has about 800 rock shelters, out of which 500 have paintings. Material used, they have used hematite known as geru. Then white might have been made out of limestone and black from wooden charcoal. So you just write that in your language. They used to make brushes with plant fiber, and what they do, they use gum from trees, and sometimes they use animal fat for mixing as a glue. And these powders, like they use lime powder and mix animal fat in that for making the thick substance of color. And subject matter, then come to subject matter, and like what types of paintings have been painted in that, that is the animals such as bison, tiger, rhinoceros, and Bhimbetka paintings portray live records of development of style and the liner representation. If you want to write that, you can. Otherwise, just write the subject matter, whatever has been painted in that. Like themes are taken from everyday events. The scenes usually depict hunting, dancing horse and elephant riders, animal fights, etc. So this is the question you need to cover when you have to write about Bhimbetka caves. Now, wizard dance. This painting is in Bhimbetka caves, this painting. So if you want to dictate this question, what you have to do, you need to write the medium that is made with mineral colors and it is on stone. The base is stone. Then location is Bhimbetka caves. Just write that only. Then courtesy, that is National Museum, New Delhi, Center of Cultural Resources and Training Center, New Delhi. Then subject matter is the ceremonial dance of wizard like cave men to depict some joyful celebration or some ritualistic dance to please the god. See, this is the subject matter of this painting. And the description, the painting is on the wall of in the Bhimbetka of MP. This is perhaps the earliest example of development of music and dance, theater and use of masks. See, these masks has been shown in this painting. The one on one side, there is a figure standing in joyful mood with open arm. So you need to dictate that painting in your language. Just read that and after that dictate this in your language. Our next painting is in Bhimbetka cave, is that is roaring animal. You need to learn these two paintings. One is wizard dance and the other one is roaring animal. Again, the medium is same, mineral color stone. Location Bhimbetka caves. And the courtesy, again same, the Central of Cultural Resources and Training Center. Subject matter is hunting scene depicting supremacy of human on the other animals in the prehistoric era. And description, again read this and write that in your language. Just read this and go through this painting and you will come to know like whatever has been drawn in this. Like they have depicted that one animal is roaring towards a man standing in the center of the composition. See, this man is in the center of this composition. And one on one side, a peacock-like bird can also be seen along with other animal like bull. So you need to describe this in your language. Then come to our next chapter, that is Art of Indus Valley. And here you need to learn Mother Goddess. Medium is terracotta, baked clay. And no need to write period. And then location is Mohenjo-daro and the collection is National Museum, New Delhi. This sculpture is in National Museum, New Delhi. And theme again, terracotta idol of fertility goddess. So again, read this and describe this in your language. That is very easy. The significance of the broad pan like attachment on the both sides of the hairdo. See, these are the pan like attachment. Then our next painting from Mohenjo-daro is Dancing Girl. You need to write description into 5 to 10 lines. So first write that and after that theme and subject matter, and then description should be in 5 to 10 lines. So Dancing Girl, the medium is bronze and location again Mohenjo-daro. And collection is National Museum, New Delhi. A small bronze statue of a dancing girl. This is one of the greatest achievement of artist of Mohenjo-daro at the Masters of Miniatures. The bronze statue of dancing girl is only 4 inches high. That is approx like this only. And just the girl, the female figure standing in Tribhanga pose. Tribhanga pose is this. Like keeping your hand on the waist, and this is the Tribhanga pose, and as if relaxing after dance number, with her right hand resting on her hip and the left entirely covered with the bangles, resting on the left leg forward. So write this into your language, take a screenshot of this and you can read that. Then come to our next chapter, that is Buddhist, Jain and Hindu art. So here you need to learn this only. No need to learn description in this. That is loin capital from Sarnath. Medium is polished sandstone and must learn period in this. Circa 3rd century BC and density is Mauryan Ashok. And Sarnath Archaeological Museum, UP. The collection is in Sarnath. So you need to learn theme and subject matter of this loin capital of Sarnath. Only this. No need to learn description in this. Then Bodhisattva head from Taxila. Our next painting from Hindu Jain and Buddhist Hindu and Jain chapter. That is Bodhisattva head from Taxila and medium is stone. Period is 2nd century AD, Kushan and Gandhara school. The city is Kushan and Gandhara school, must learn that. And collection is National Museum, New Delhi. Theme and subject matter, again learn this. Till here you need to learn this. A fine museum quality, second stone head of Bodhisattva in thoughtful expression, carved with well-defined features. So you need to learn this only. Then come to Jain Tirthankara. The medium is stone and period is circa 5th century AD and density is Gupta. And courtesy is State Museum, Lucknow. And again, till this, you need to learn the famous Jain deity seated in Padmasana. Now our next main chapter is the Art of Ajanta. That is a very main chapter of your book. And here is the introduction. You'll just write this in your language. Ajanta is a great art treasure and it is known as golden period of that time, Indian art. And discovery that was discovered by some tiger hunting British soldiers who saw that this collection of caves first time. And that is in horse shoe shaped narrow valley. It is like that. So that is in Aurangabad. The art of Ajanta was exposed to the fascinated world. So location of these caves are, that is in situated in Aurangabad district of Maharashtra state. Only this you need to learn. And there is a small hill of about 300 feet height, a crescent moon formation or in a horseshoe formation. It is like that. I have told you earlier. So the time period is, that is 2nd century BC to 6th century AD. And no need to learn first phase, second phase. Now number of caves. How many caves are there? Art of Ajanta is a complex 29 Chaityas and Vihara caves. Chaitya caves are those caves there where the places of worship and religious discussion has been done. And Vihara caves are those caves where both Bhikshuk, they were the living place for both Bhikshuks. These were the Vihara caves were the living places for the both Bhikshuks. So, cave number 1, that is 21 feet long, is the biggest cave. And which is the home of figure of painting of Padmapani. Padmapani is the very famous painting of art of Ajanta. And cave number 29 is the best stupa caves. Stupa means Chaitya cave, jahan pe aap puja worship wagera rehte hai. And cave number 17 is the highest number of paintings are there. So how many types of caves are there? One is Chaitya cave. Chaitya cave, I have told you earlier that these were the places of worship and religious discussion. And the Vihara caves, they were the living places for both Bhikshuks. So technique of Ajanta and fresco murals, you must know about that. Ajanta fresco were done in tempera style. The surface of places where painting was made of rough using some tools. Like what they do, wo diwaron ko pehle stone ke saath pehle usko rough karte the, and after that they mix plaster in which they have stone powder, cow dung and rice straw, and they'll just mix that, and after that they have applied it on that wall. And after that what they will do, they'll just take one bamboo stick and start flattening that. After this they apply the lime paste on it, which was treated like a painting surface, and then they draw the drawing with red color. After this they fill color in that, and this is how they finish their drawing. Then again, colors of Ajanta, they used natural white color was prepared from limestone or chalk, blue from neem plant, that which is known as indigo. Later on, lapis lazuli. Lapis lazuli is like stone which is having blue pigment. So they use these kind of stones and natural colors. Then no need to learn this difference between the fresco and murals. Subject matter of art Ajanta painting. Subject matter, what are the subject matters are of that painting? That is Buddha's life and his teaching. Buddha's intelligence, noble character, selfless service and compassion are illustrated on these timeless wall with the help of Jataka tails, the previous birth of Buddha. Jataka tails are known as the previous births of Buddha. That is enough for Art of Ajanta. Now, you need to do this painting, that is Bodhisattva Padmapani. And this is in the cave number 1 of Ajanta and again Aurangabad. And the courtesy is Archaeological Survey of India. And medium is fresco mural painting. Theme, painting of Bodhisattva torso is in sublime pose. Painting of Bodhisattva torso is on sublime pose. Description, again write this in your language. Just read that and go through this painting. You can take screenshot of this. They have just explained this painting in their language. So you need to describe this in your language. Like he wears a pearl necklace, a big intricate crown made with sapphire, the long string diagonally worn over the left shoulder. See, so what they have seen in this painting, they have just written on this page. So please do it very carefully. All the best. Bye-bye.